Dear friends, in class 11 we are studying complex numbers and the next point is identities. So here algebraic identities hold true for the complex numbers. So if here identity z1 plus z2 bracket square is equal to z1 plus z2 into z1 plus z2. So this is equal to z1 into z1 is z1 square plus z1 into z2 is z1 z2, plus z2 into z1 is equal to z2 z1, and this is equal to z2 square. Now we have already studied that this is one and the same. Z2 z1 is one and the same, so this becomes z1 square plus twice z1 z2 plus z2 square. Please note, this identity is similar to our a plus b bracket square is equal to a square plus twice ab plus b square. So same identity holds for the complex number as well. Now let us consider the z1 minus z2 bracket square. So for this also, this is equal to z1 minus z2 into z1 minus z2. So this is equal to z1 into z1 is z1 square minus z1 z2 now z2 z1 minus z2 z1, minus minus will become plus z2 square. Please note, we have already studied in properties, in algebraic properties, that z1 z2 is equal to z2 z1. It means this is equal to z1 square. Negative negative adds, we get negative z1 twice z1 z2 plus z2 square. Now next identity is z1 square plus z2 square, or you can say z1 plus z2 multiplied by z1 minus z2. So if you multiply this, let's see what we get. We will get z1 into z1 is z1 square, z1 into z2 is negative z1 z2, z2 into z1 is positive z2 z1, and z2 into z2 is negative z2 square. Please note, we have already studied z1 z2 is equal to z2 z1, so these terms cancel each other. We are left with z1 square plus z2 square. This second property is, second identity is equal to a minus b bracket square is equal to a square minus twice ab plus b square. And third identity, a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. This is what we have already studied. Now if you go for a minus b bracket cube, a minus b bracket cube, let us see, in case of complex number it will be z1 minus z2 bracket cube. Now this is equal to z1 minus z2 multiplied by z1 minus z2 bracket square. Now bracket square identity we have already studied, z1 minus z2 bracket square is this, so you will get z1 minus z2 multiplied by z1 square minus twice z1 z2 plus z2 square. Now first bracket multiplied by second bracket, it means we have to multiply by each term to each term, so you will get z1 into z1 square. This is equal to z1 cube. This will be negative twice z1 square z2. Then first term multiplied by third term is positive z1 into z2 square. Now multiply by second term to all terms in the second bracket, you will get negative z2 into z1 square, z2 into z1 square. Now this is negative, this is also negative, so it will become positive twice z1 z2 square. And last will be positive into negative is negative, you will get z2 cube. So please now note, this is twice z1 z2 square and this is z. Now we have already studied z1 into z2 is equal to z2 into z1. So in order to avoid confusion, I will write all the terms in terms of z1, z2 so that you will not get confused. This is equal to z1 cube minus twice z1 square into z2 plus z1 into z2 square. This can be written for z1 square into z2 plus twice z1 into z2 square minus z2 cube. Now please note, this is z1 square z2 and this is also z1 square z2. Here please note, it is negative 2, negative 1. So these terms will get added. We will get first term as it is. This is equal to z1 cube twice negative and negative 1 will be negative 3. z1 square z2. This is again, please note, positive z1 z2 square. z1 z2 square will get added. This is 1, this is 2, so it will become plus. Plus 3. z1 z2 square minus z2 cube. So you will notice that this comes to a minus b bracket cube. Now a minus b bracket cube, we have already studied, is equal to a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. Please note, negative terms are alternate. So this is what we have studied, same terms we get. z1 cube minus 3z1 square z2 plus 3z1 z2 square minus z2 cube. Let's see the next identity, z1 plus z2 bracket cube. Now this is equal to z1 plus z2 multiplied by z1 plus z2 bracket square. That is same term is multiplied, I have split the cube into 1 into 2, powers into 1 into 2. Now this we have already studied earlier, so this is equal to z1 plus z2. The second bracket is z1 square plus twice z1 z2 plus z2 square. So if you multiply this, you will get first term multiplied by whole bracket, you will get z1 into z1 square is z1 cube plus twice z1 square into z2 plus z1 into z2 square. So I have multiplied by first term to all terms in the second bracket. Now I am multiplying by second term to the whole bracket. So I will get z1 square z2. I have written z1 term front first and then z2 term. Please note, here if you multiply this, I will get plus twice z1 z2 square. If you multiply by this, I will get z2 cube. So please note, z1 square z2 can be added. So this is equal to z1 cube plus 3z1 square z2. Now this will also get added, z1 z2 square. So this will be plus 3z1 z2 square plus z2 cube. Please note, we have got the same property which we have got in algebraic identities, that is a plus b bracket cube is equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. And similarly, we can prove that many more identities are true for complex numbers as well.